My name is Leanne, and this is Phoebe from As You Like It, Act 3, Scene 5. Tis but a peevish boy. Yet, he talks well. But what care I for words? Yet, words do well when he that speaks them pleases those that hear. It is a pretty youth. Not very pretty, but sure he's proud. And yet his pride becomes him. He'll make a proper man. The best thing in him is his complexion. And faster than his tongue did make offense, his eye did heal it up. He is not very tall, yet for his years he's tall. His leg is but so-so. And yet 'tis well. There was a pretty redness in his lip, a little riper, and more lusty red than that mixed in his cheek. 'Twas just the difference between the constant red and mingled damask. There be some women, Silvius, had they marked him in parcels as I did, would have gone near to fall in love with him. But for my part, I love him not, nor hate him not. But I have more cause to hate him than to love him. For what did he to do to chide at me? Boo! Sonnet 19. Devouring time, blunt thou the lion's paws, and make the earth devour her own sweet brood. Pluck the keen teeth from the fierce tiger's jaws, and burn the long-lived phoenix in her blood. Make glad and sorry seasons as thou fleet'st, and do whate'er thou wilt, swift-footed time, to the wide world and all her fading sweets. But I forbid thee one most heinous crime. Oh, carve not with thy hours my love's fair brow, nor draw no lines there with thine antique pen. Him in thy course untainted do allow for beauty's pattern in succeeding men. Yet do thy worst, old time. Despite thy wrong, my love shall in my verse ever live young. Oh, and I, forsooth, in love, I, that have been love's whip, what I love, I sue, I seek a wife, a woman that is like a German clock. Still repairing, ever out of frame, and never going aright, being a watch, but being watched that it may still go right. Nay, to be perjured, which is worst of all, and among three to love the worst of all. A whitely wanton with a velvet brow, and two pitch balls stuck in her face for eyes. Aye, and by heaven, one that will do the deed, though Argus be her eunuch and her guard. And I to sigh for her, to watch for her, to pray for her, go to. It is a plague that Cupid will impose for my neglect of his almighty dreadful little might. Well, I will love, write, sigh, pray, sue, groan. Some men must love my love, and some Joan. Thank you.